Mike Dell's World, number 129 for July 1st. Wow, rabbit, rabbit, rabbit. July 1st, 2009. That song was called Let It Rain. That's by Amanda Marshall. And I think I got that off of the PodSafe Music Network. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whatever the case may be. This is Mike, and of course, this is Mike Dell's World, number 129 for July 1st, 2009. It's July already. Wow. It doesn't feel like July. In fact, it's downright cold here in Traverse City. I don't know about cold, but it's definitely not July 1st weather. Well, let me look here. I'll find the actual current temperature here. Here, I'll give the weather report like I do at my WNMC radio show. And okay, conditions now at Cherry Capital Airport is 54 degrees Fahrenheit, 12 Celsius, with light rain and fog and mist. Today, showers likely cloudy and high near 60. North winds around 5 miles per hour. Chance of precipitation, 70%. Tonight, a 30% chance of rain or drizzle. Cloudy with a low around 53. Northwest winds between 5 and 10 miles per hour. tomorrow, a 30% chance of rain or drizzle, cloudy with a high near 67. Northwest wind between 5 and 10 miles per hour. Anyway, that was my real fake radio announcer voice, such as it is. Anyway, glad you guys stopped in here. Yeah, it's been raining, hence the song Let It Rain. And like I said, it's kind of a theme today, although you know, I don't want to sit here and talk about the weather. I've been prepping all week for a camping trip, our first camping trip of the year. I went and retrieved the camper on Monday from storage. You know, July 1st, and I'm just getting the thing out of winter storage. Tell you what kind of year we're having here. Really busy is the main problem. So anyway, got the camper into town. Had to pump up a couple of tires before I left the storage facility at my dad's farm there. So, but pumped up the tires on one side. It's weird. On the right side, both tires on the right side of the camper trailer went flat. But both tires on the left side of the camper are holding air from about 4 years ago. I haven't had to even top them off. Sitting there right at 40 PSI. So I don't know what's going on. But anyway, got the tires filled up and got the thing into town. Put the awning out. You know, Monday, of course, it wasn't raining. But put the awning out just to let it air out and all that good stuff. I come home from work yesterday, Tuesday. And, you know, of course, it had rained like crazy all overnight. And it had collapsed one side of the awning. Not really collapsed it, but, you know, when so much weight gets into the awning, it pushes a little things down that hold up the awning to where it will dump the water off. So come home and it's in that state. So I put the other side down so it was kind of, you know, there at a 45 degree angle to let the rain run off it. You know, it'll handle light rain, and if you set it up just right, it'll, you know, it'll drain off, but I didn't have it just right. So anyway, I figured, oh, okay, well, I'll just leave it down like that, and tomorrow morning, which is today, I'll be able to put it back up because it'll be, you know, dry. Well, it's not dry. We've got a low pressure system just hovering over our area here, and it hasn't moved hardly at all in 2 days. It's actually supposed to blow out of here by tomorrow night. So, but anyway, I put the awning up anyway, rolled it up. And, let's see, I had to change the doorknob on the trailer. Lots of little maintenance items in the spring. But I got the doorknob changed, and I've been working on the Cadillac a little bit. Put a new serpentine belt on it. That's our camper towing vehicle. Put a new serpentine belt on it. Got the trailer wiring hookup replaced yesterday. And got the door fixed on Monday. The door on the Cadillac for about the last couple of weeks, the inside door handle was inoperative. So you had to roll the window down and let yourself out. Of course, it's electric windows. So you had to leave the thing run or leave the key on, run the window down, open the door, and then run the window back up. Then you could shut it off and get out. Well, that got old really fast, so I took it over to a local mechanic here, and he fixed it right up. And, now it's as good as new. I can get in and out of the driver's side of the truck without having to roll the window down and look stupid. And especially with it raining like this the last couple of days, that's really nice. Okay, well, I'm still using my my newest audio setup. I don't want to make this all about inside podcasting, but hopefully I've got the audio levels figured out. I got one more piece to the puzzle that I'm going to be adding here really soon. I've finally gotten tired of this condenser microphone, and I'm going to go ahead and bite the bullet, and I'm going to order a PR40 Heil microphone. I don't know whether I'll be doing it in the next week or two, but definitely before too long, I will be on a Heil. That way, I know everybody says, I can't hear any of the background noise you say that you hear. Well, I hear it, and it's got to be in there. And the Heil will take care of that. And you know, it's just a better dynamic microphone. I was going to go big bucks and get the Electra Voice RE20, but with all the vehicle maintenance, I figured that extra $150 that an RE20 would cost can go for vehicle maintenance instead, and I'll settle with the PR40. Actually, PR40 is probably just as good. I just like the Electra Voice because that's what I use at the radio station. So we're going to be going to an undisclosed location in Michigan. We're not leaving the state, but we're going to be taking off Friday sometime and not returning till Monday. But I have on a good authority that we will be podcast producing while on the camping trip. Kathy and I are probably going to do a Mike Dell's World edition, you know, with guests. Well, with Kathy. She's been on here way back in the Benzoid Report days. But she promised me she'd sit down at the table in the camper with the portable recording set up. And I know, I know it doesn't sound as good, but it'll probably sound okay for what we're going to do. Of course, I'm going to bring the portable recorder. And, maybe while we're walking around the campground or going to visit this place or that place around the area that we're going to be at, which is another tourist area. Of course, you know, it's kind of silly. I live in a tourist area, and I'm going to go to another tourist area not too far away. But we just really need to get away. We've had the teenager in our custody for the entire school year, and that has now come to an end. The teenager arrived in Florida yesterday afternoon, and he's back with his dad. So he's off our shoulders. And it's just been a really busy spring and early summer. And Kathy and I just decided that, you know what, we just need to get away. Need to get somewhere where we're not near her family, we're not near my family. And like I said, I don't mind being around my family. I've been around my family a lot lately, and that's fine. But, you know, we want to go somewhere where, we're just going to set the camper up on a campsite for 3 days, or 4 days and 3 nights, actually, and have no agenda. You know, not the same no agenda that Adam Curry and John C. Dvorak have, although that's an interesting podcast you should check out if you don't listen to it. It's totally different than any anything else that either of them have done previous. But, it's just we don't have any parties, any get-togethers to attend, don't have any anything, you know. It's just going to be me, the wife, and the dog in a campground. And the weather's supposed to be just perfect as far as I'm concerned. It's supposed to blow this rain out of here and out of the rest of the state, and it's going to be in the 70s and dry, not humid, and partly cloudy, which means or is it mostly sunny? I think it's partly cloudy, they said, and I guess that means more sun than clouds, but you know, I don't mind a little shade, you know, in the end of the, in the middle of the day. And of course we'll have the camper with the awning, so we'll be sitting in our lawn chairs out there, bringing the laptops, and you know, we're gonna stay mostly unplugged, but got some writing projects that we need to do, and like I said, we're gonna shoot for maybe recording podcast number 130 for Mike Dell's World from the campground. Like I said, I do have that snowflake microphone. I know it doesn't sound as good as my normal setup, but I think it'll work just great for two of us. What I'm going to do is I'll set that up right in the middle of the kitchen table in the camper, and we should both sound okay on it. Let's hope so. I'm looking forward to seeing how that sounds. And if all else fails, we got this portable recorder. I can just stick the mic on it and pass it back and forth. But, yeah, that's not as fun. So, anyway, I'm going to play another tune here. And like I said, hopefully I've got the audio worked out. But if I don't, I will. Like I said, there's a lot of moving parts here. I'm actually not recording to the computer. I'm recording to the portable recorder. And I've got my patented, it's not working, but I got my patented gym sock stuck over the MXL770 microphone for a windscreen. So anyway, I'm going to play a tune from Jonathan Colton. And it's called The Famous Blue Raincoat.
It's 4 in the morning, the end of December. I'm writing you now just to see if you're better. New York is cold, but I like where I'm living. There's music on Clinton Street all through the evening. I hear that you're building your little house deep in the desert. You're living for nothing now. I hope you're keeping some kind of record. Yes, and Jane came by with a lock of your hair. She said that you gave it to her that night when you planned to go clear. Did you ever go clear? The last time we saw you, you looked so much older. Your famous blue raincoat was torn at the shoulder. You'd been to the station to meet every train. You came home without Lily Marlene, and you treated my woman to a flake of your life. When she came back, she was nobody's wife. And I see you there with a rose in your teeth. One more thin gypsy thief. Will I see Jane's awake? She sends her regards. Can I tell you, my brother, my killer? What can I possibly say? I guess that I miss you, I guess I forgive you. I'm glad that you stood in my way. If you ever come by here for Jane or this woman is free. Yes, and thanks for the trouble you took from her eyes. I thought it was there for good, so I never tried. And Jane came by with a lock of your hair. She said that you gave it to her that night when you planned to go clear. Sincerely, El Cohen.
You're listening to Mike Dell on Mike Dell's World from high atop the MDW building in Traverse City, Michigan.
And we're back. Traverse City, Michigan. There's no MDW building. And actually, I'm in the basement, so I don't know what Jim was talking about. Anyway, that was Jim Farley of Musical World and the PodSafe Music Network. And of course, What's Up With That, which we haven't done in a while. Well, so be it. Let's see, what else is interesting? Well, of course, you know, all these celebrity deaths. Something else, you know, it's sad, you know, I'll agree. Although, I think they're going a little overboard on the Michael Jackson thing. I guess it was Monday morning. I watched some of the Today Show on NBC, and really it was the Michael Jackson Memorial Show. And I kind of feel sorry for Farrah Fawcett, dying on the same day as Michael Jackson, because, you know, she got dropped like a hot potato. You know, it was a big deal up until the Jackson thing happened. And then, here's a couple of interesting things that I've heard on other podcasts and, you know, some of my own stuff. But John C. Dvorak, of course you know him from Twit, Tech TV, back in the day, from Cranky Geeks, No Agenda with Adam Curry, and you know, countless other stuff, Market Watch, I don't know, he writes a bunch of columns. But anyway, he has a theory that, you know, all these celebrity deaths come in threes. Well, if you count David Carradine, and then you got Michael Jackson, and Farrah Fawcett, and Ed McMahon. Okay, but if you consider Ed McMahon as a pitch man instead of a celebrity, so then you got just David Carradine, Michael Jackson, and Farrah Fawcett, there's the three celebrities. And then if you count pitchmen, you got Ed McMahon and Billy Mays. And then, Dvorak's theory is there's one more pitch man, you know, to come to make the three. But let's say you don't count David Carradine. And so you got Ed McMahon, Farrah Fawcett, Michael Jackson. There's your three. And then you leave it to Billy Mays to throw in an extra. Absolutely free. I know that's terrible, but I just thought that was that was funny, and I believe that Billy would think it was funny. So anyway, and people have told me all I need to do is dye my beard black like he did, and I'd look somewhat like him. I would have to, I don't. My hair's not dark enough. Okay, maybe I'm full of shit. Anyway, all righty. Well, I'm going to play another tune here. And this one I'm playing blind. I know I've played it before, you know, 100 years ago, because I have it on my computer, so I know I've actually heard it before, but it's called Gee, I'm Glad It's Raining.
Gee, I'm glad it's raining. There's always something to be thankful for. I'm awfully glad it's raining, 'cause no one sees the teardrops when it pours. And no one knows a thunder as your heart breaks in disguise. And they think all the rainy nights cause a sadness in your eyes. Raining, this gentle river soothes the pain inside. I'm glad the stars aren't shining. This wounded soldier needs a place to hide. I thought I had found someone I could count on. To the end, she wanted a hero. All I needed was a friend. Gee, I'm glad it's raining. I hope the morning sun don't come up soon. Keeps raining, no one knows my heart broke right in two. Thank you.
Okay, I believe that was Rob Coslow, and the song's called After the Rain. I'm not positive it's Rob Coslow, so your mileage may vary. Before that, we heard Glad It's Raining, and I have no earthly idea where that come from, but I will look that up and try to put that in the show notes. No guarantees, as is normal. I promise to put stuff in the show notes, and sometimes it doesn't show up. So, anyway, sounds like my phone's ringing, but I am going to put that on ignore. And I know who that is, and I will call them back. Because I haven't figured a good way to pause this this podcast the way I'm doing it. I have to ponder that. Let me do a test here, so I'll let you know how it turned out. I don't think there's a way to do it. Hang on. No, I'm not going to try it. I think maybe there is a way to pause the digital recorder, but that's probably best tested when I'm not recording a podcast and, you know, over 30 minutes into it. I do know that I need to make sure I'm up on the mic here and don't turn away like this, because it definitely makes a difference in my headphones. Hopefully it doesn't make too much of a problem with you guys. Of course, I could really screw with you. I got a new button here. There I am over on the left, and here I am over on the right. And if you didn't hear me on the left and the right, or if I, when I said left, I was on the right, you got your headphones on backwards. Anyway, okay, I'm getting punchy. I haven't had enough sleep lately, so I'm going to play one more song, and I won't be back afterwards. So feel free to hit the fast forward if you don't like banjo music. But I'm going to play one, another one from the Detour Bluegrass Band here locally here in Traverse City. This is called The Winds of Winfield. And these guys are good. Even if you don't appreciate bluegrass, you might still appreciate what these guys can do with a banjo and a mandolin. It's pretty amazing. So, anyway, thanks for downloading this podcast or pushing the play button on the website. Oh, by the way, there's a new voicemail line. I did get my Google Voice number finally, and just for you guys on the podcast, it's area code 231-715-1366. And if you I would appreciate if you guys would give me a call and leave a voicemail, hell, you might even get me to talk to you if I'm awake. But anyway, that's area code 231-715-1366. And I really do want to try this out, the Google Voice. It's the old Grand Central thing. If you go to the website at www.mikedell.com, you'll find there's a Talk to Me button. If you have, I don't know what you even need to have. Somebody try that too. Click the Talk to Me button. There on the right-hand side of the website, or call me button. I don't know what it says. It's got like kind of a thing. But anyway, I think it uses Google Talk or some other VoIP type thing. So if you get a mic on your computer, be able to leave me a message that way. Or like I said, if I happen to be awake, you might even be able to actually talk to me. Yeah, like that's a big deal. Anyway, I'm going to play this song and go to bed. This is The Winds of Winfield by Detour, the bluegrass band local to Traverse City, Michigan. Have a great day. Catch me later.
Thank you.